Rodney Erdickson here with my favorite stunt series bike race, the Afterburner. As far as I'm concerned, if all the bike races were as spectacular as this one, I would really have an appreciation for the bike races in the stunt series. As you can tell, you have these dramatic jumps. Oh! Which lead to crazy descents above Los Santos. Here's my buddy right next to him. I'm gonna use these accelerator pads. I'm not sure, but I wouldn't be surprised if this is one of the highest suspended stunt tracks in Grand Theft Auto Online. My buddy did quite a tilt, but didn't go for the full flip. On a bike, you could lower yourself in order to get more speed. Get better aerodynamics. Aerodynamics, excuse me, I got a little tongue-tied there. As you can see, the actual track pieces are not suspended by any sort of supports or any sort of architecture. I don't think stunt tracks are supposed to be based out of a realistic approach. Instead, it's more fantasy, but still spectacular in its own right. This time we'll take the left path. Not much difference out of the two. Show stunt cam there, so you have an idea of what it looks like. Went for a little wheelie. As you can tell, the downside to lowering yourself on your bike in order to get more speed is landings are a lot rougher and a lot less precise, since your body isn't poised to absorb the dispersion of the landing. Stunt cam, why not? I could turn it off right before I land. But it got a lot more airtime than I did there. With the ramps and the checkered pattern, it kind of reminds me of a Sonic game. Casino Nights. He'll end it. This will be tricky. Alright. Had to bank somewhat. Getting down to the wire. I don't know how that happened. I don't even know if it counted that I bested you. Really? I didn't see any indication that I was getting the split. Well, maybe. There you go, my favorite stunt bike track in GTA Online, the Stunt series.